Hello everyone, in this tutorial I am going to use link on files that find the file informations and using link. And I am going to make a table with the name of file, the size, the directory name and directory, if it is read-only, extension, creation time, last access time, last write time. And I am going to use a tanker to show the when I select a file, a directory, how many files the directory contains, and it shows there. And down here I am going, when we press on any of those rows, the information, the name and the extension, and the file the extension is up here, and we can also steer it, the file which size of files we want show between which values. And for this I am going to start a new project, Windows form application. And in this Windows form application I am going to add a data grid view from toolbox and put it here. And the size, I am going to change the size as 960 until 400, and I am going to use the change the form size at 1130 and 500, and then I am going to use the label, call it name, another label extension, a text box, and another text box for extension. And I am going to have a button and then change its name, or change its text, change directory. Instead of, I use while loop for if you want continue or not, I am using that one. You check first one directory, and then you want see another directory, you are going to press that one, and it you choose another directory. And I am going to use a numeric up down here. And we are going to use the increment with 1, maximum size 1 million, and minimum size is 0, and it must be less than, and the value is 1 million. The value I have chosen 1 million. And the minimum value, and for this I have chosen the value 0, and it starts 0. Okay, and then I am, in order to use this tank, you must install National Instruments CVI and Measurement Studio 2015 or earlier. And in this toolbox you are going to right click on general and use new tab and change the name as Measurement Studio, and on this Measurement Studio right click and choose items, you are going down to tank. Tank for Windows Forms. Those two you select and then press OK. And then you put it here, and here or there in properties, you are going to change the for a color to lime, and then you are going to and fill style to solid, and you are going to change the range. Change the range from 0 to 2500 eventually in files in one direction, in one directory. Okay, then we are going to only double click on change directory, and in this form one class you are going up there, and you are going to define two objects in as class variable, one delicate void set data source handle, and then one directory info directory base. And as you know, delegate is a function pointer, and it's very proper for our program. And in form one load, you can double click on form one, double click, and it appear this one, and you use this with 1130, and you are going to use the method function form one shown, and it is using change path, which is a method, and this is because you must be sure that the form is appear, and then you are going to use numeric value changed, define this one, and use load data true to reload, and then we are going to have a data grid view cell mouse click, and you are going to select this, and under here cell content name cell must clicked, we are going to double click here, and it appear here, and we are going to to use it when we want select each row that get information if the row index is bigger than 0 and is less than the total number of rows, then we are going to use dynamic data grid view row get row index data bound item, and we are going to also put the item of the length of the grid view in the tank, and we are going to see if phi is not null, then text box file name, which is this one, is equals to path dot get file name without extension fee name, and text box file extension dot text fee extension dot trim start with dot. Then we are going to have a button change directory, and we use change path, and in change path we are going to use folder browser dialog fbd new folder browser dialog. If it is okay, if there exists such a file, then we are going to use the dbase new directory info of the fbd selected path, and we are going to load the data, and then we are going to load data, which is a task we have used it, and in this namespaces we have added system IO, system link, system threading tasks, and then in load we are going to return task run, and it is a lambda expression. Long mean is numeric up down minimum value, which is this one, and it's the greater the maximum value is the maximum value, and we are going to have a variable data, and here we use the link from f in dbase dot get files, which has all of them any extension, any extension. If it is recursive, then search option all the directories. If it is not, use search option top directory only. And where f length is bigger than mean and f length is less than max, and it is ordered by name, and then select f. If you select f, it's coming all those information about the file, but because we only want these items, name, size, directory name, directory is read only, extension, creation time, last access time, and last write time, then we are going to use new f.name, f.length, f.directory name, and so on. And then after that, we are going to set data source data dot to list, is connected to a list, and then we are going to put the number of items in the grid view in the tanker. And because we have used the here in set data source object, we are going to invoke. If it is invoked and it is recursive, we are going to use a data source handle, set data source, and we are going to invoke d with object. And if it is not invoked, it only put the object in grid view, and also put it in the tanker the number of rows. Okay, and it was all. Now function. Okay, for insurance, I have used the asynchronous task directory size to find the size of directory, and if it was if we wanted show the size of directory, it is only copy and copy these rows and put it in your program. It's good to have it. Okay, now I am going to run. Here I use the desktop. I have enough files, and it is almost 500 files. And when I am going to press on this, it appears access 14, and extension is Opal, and all those files you can see here. And I am going to use between 1000. And it is almost the same. You are going to use between 10,000 and it is 400 or 390. We can see here. And this one has another extension. This one has MSE, XML, XE, and you are going to see here. I am going to use change the directory, and I am going to use in this PC document, and I am going to use Visual Studio 2015, and I am going to use to see all the, and it takes time because it is very big, and you see that it is almost 2000, and I am going to change it as 0 until and it is almost, and we are going to use 20,000, and it is almost 1400, and I am going to use that one. It hasn't any name, its extension is SUO, and you are going down. And it up here, BD, VSH, and antivirus, and runtime. It's another, it is banner, RAR, PNG, and so on. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. Thank you for watching. See you in next tutorial.